Metro, I don't trust you, I'm gon' shoot.
What's up, everyone? Welcome to the 184th edition of the Sports Reality. My name is Jeremy John, here to bring to you all things sports. We have a lot to get into, and it is, I'm all over the place. We have a lot to get to, but it's a great day out here in the DMV. Wonderful weather, not just here, kind of in the mid-Atlantic, great weather. So I hope you all enjoy that. It is President's Day, I guess. So some people are off, so I guess it's a holiday for some. Not a holiday for everyone, but a holiday for some nonetheless. Let's welcome my man, Mike Phillips, in the building.
Yo! Wow, that's loud. I got to not be so loud. Turn me down a little bit. I don't want to mess the audio quality up.
How's everything going, Mike?
Going good, man. Just hey, Morgan. Good morning. So yeah, everything's good, man. All Star Weekend was this past weekend. So.
Yep. Definitely gonna get into that. So did you catch anything?
I mean, I caught some memes. I caught I saw like the halftime score was like ridiculous.
Yeah, I mean, it's an all-star game.
Oh my god. I mean, but it's never been this ridiculous. Like, this game could have went to like 300 points if they didn't slow down.
I mean, it's the all-star game, and I get annoyed when people say, well, I mean, there was no defense. I mean,
Steph Curry laid down.
Yes,
the floor.
Because he got dunked on the possession before. Yes. He's like, I ain't getting posterized anymore. So I'm not about that life. I might as well just be a spectator. I'm going to just lie down on the floor. Hey, man. But you just asked me a question a couple minutes ago. Snoop Dogg said something about the All-Star game. What did Snoop Dogg say, man?
He was talking about the All-Star game. Let me look it up, actually. It's actually really funny. So just give me a second.
No problem.
What's going on in today's history and hip hop though? Not hip hop. Today's history and sports.
I mean, I can check that up too. But yeah, today in sports history, today is February 20th, 2017, and on February 20th, 1887. Woo, 100 years before we were born, Mike.
Oh wow.
The first minor league baseball association was organized in Pittsburgh. 1929 on this day, the Boston Red Sox announced that they would begin playing games on Sunday. I didn't know there were a time they didn't play games on Sundays.
Yeah.
I know baseball, there's always a game Friday, Saturday, Sunday, no matter what. There's always a game. 1930, Clint Benedict of the Montreal Maroons became the first goalie to wear a mask in the NHL. Benedict wore the mask temporarily during an injury. Wow. Yeah, I mean, I've seen, you know, old foul videos where these goalies literally had nothing to protect them from pucks that were coming 100-plus miles toward their face. 1943, Phil Wrigley and Branch Rickey chartered the All-American Girls Softball League. Also, Branch Rickey was the general manager that signed Jackie Robinson to the Dodgers, if you do not know that. 1952, Emmett L. Ashford became the first black umpire in organized baseball. He was authorized to be a substitute in the Southwestern International League. 1958, racing jockey Eddie Arcaro got win number 4,000 as he rode the winner at Santa Anita Racetrack in Southern California. Let's move to something a little more recent. There's a lot that happened on this day. 1993, the New York Islanders retired Billy Smith's 31 jersey. Also on this day, 1993, the Florida Marlins opened their first spring training camp.
Oh, wow.
And the Marlins have two World Series wins.
But, yeah.
But outside of their two World Series wins, they're not that good. Like, it's like they've won two World Series.
Oh, there you go.
And they're not that good. You good, Mike, over there?
Yeah, I think I'm good now.
Yeah. 1997, Barry Bonds of the San Francisco Giants signed a contract worth $22.9 million over 2 years.
For 2 years?
Yep, 2 year deal. So about
hold up.
11 million a year. Great numbers back then.
My goodness.
Remember we spoke about this a couple weeks ago?
In baseball shape.
Remember we spoke about this a couple weeks ago? Yeah. And now we spoke about Garth Brooks and the Mets a couple weeks ago.
That was sad.
Well, Garth Brooks on this day in 2000 began training with the Mets. So remember a few weeks ago he signed with the Mets. Yeah.
Began training Garth Brooks.
Yeah. 2002 ESPN and the Liberty Bowl.
Does not have a athletic body.
I mean, he played in college, they said. I mean, they say he was all right in college.
Yeah, I mean, think about
it. He's Garth Brooks, and it's a promo.
And it's baseball, because baseball
is baseball.
You could definitely be a first baseman and haven't did any sit-ups in your life.
So, I mean, you just got to, have that arm. You got to move the first base and catch the ball.
Yeah, and have an arm. Like, you got to have, like, an arm.
I mean, not real. I mean, you
To get to the third base, you gotta have an arm.
I mean,
arm,
when do you throw from first to third?
A lot. You can get a lot of double plays off of the first base.
First to second, and then you gotta get back to first to get the double play.
Depending on how close from first base.
Or you
to
gotta throw
base,
home. I give you that. You gotta throw home.
Home is actually the further distance.
Yeah, you gotta throw home.
No. Home is not the further distance. Across that field is the further distance.
Boom is looking at me like. Because I don't have a hat on today. Oh. It's pretty warm outside.
I mean, it's pretty warm. And pretty much your hat collection is kind of like, half red and half blue. And the blue side is never a good team. I'm just saying.
I mean, you talking about the Wizards?
I'm not talking about the Wizards. I'm talking about that nasty gray color team.
Oh, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know who you're talking
about. Blue and gray. Still got Romo on their team.
Hey, we're going to talk about Tony Romo during this show when we talk about our NFL segment. All right, so let's go through the rundown real quick. NBA All-Star Weekend, we will get into all of that. College basketball, unfortunately, one of the local teams lost this week. We'll get into that also. There is some news coming from the NFL, even though it is the offseason. And, Mike, I know you're excited for this. Spring training has started.
Yes.
In Major League Baseball.
And remember, Garth Brooks was in spring training at one point.
Yeah, at one point. So is Tim Still Tebow. Sad. For the same organization.
Tim Tebow. Yeah.
So the same organization.
He brought it back up today. We're talking about this is his first day of spring training.
Yeah, man. He on this day in 2000, boom, he officially started training with the Mets. Nah, bang, bang, you're funny.
Exactly.
You're funny. All right, man, so let's talk about real quick college basketball this past weekend. I'm going to get into talk about the local team quickly because, I'm real. I'll talk about my favorite teams on this show because I am the host. I can do that, right, Mike?
Yeah, you can.
I can that.
And you allow me to get to hate at least one of your teams. Actually, it's only one, actually.
Yeah, I mean, you only hate one of my teams.
Because all the rest of them, we're both kind of like, fans of, so.
Anyways, the Maryland Terrapins lost
this
weekend yesterday to Wisconsin.
Okay,
and,
understandable.
You say what?
I said, okay, that's understandable.
And they were winning at halftime. 33-27, got outscored in the second half, 44-27 in the second half. Maryland just couldn't.
Wisconsin's
number 11 in the nation. You're right.
I was gonna say, yeah.
They are number 11 in the nation.
They didn't lose to no scrubs.
And they were on the road. However, I mean, as a Terp fan, you're still like, man, like, we were winning. Yes, I understand the 6 points at halftime.
Maryland's right where again?
Maryland's 23. Now, they may drop. After this loss, maybe
they might be out.
Maybe the 24-25, just because it's the number 11th team in the nation. But they're still there. They're still competitive. They, of course, will make the tournament unless they make a drastic fall the next couple weeks. But their record, they're 22-5. I mean, 10-4 in the Big Ten. And even though they're 10-4 in the Big Ten, they are still only one game behind Wisconsin for the lead. With, I think, 3 or 4 games left. So they can still win the regular season title. And then, you know, you never know. They can probably make the run in the Big Ten title, Big Ten tournament. By the way, Mike.
Yeah.
Did you know this? And I found this out this week. The Big Ten tournament's here at the Verizon Center.
What?
Yeah. I'll tell you why I found that out later. But it is here. Okay, so maybe we need to make an attempt to go to the Big Ten tournament.
I think I'm going to have to do that this year.
Yeah, I might have to lay a couple bucks down.
Last year, I know.
Last year, the ACC was here. And that was good. My brother went.
I mean, that was great. That was wonderful for people that had tickets. Yeah, that's wonderful. But the people that, like, commute back and forth, that shit was frustrating. It was frustrating, dude.
It was not fun, to be honest.
Like, because, like, you, like, oh, yeah, let's go to 7th Street. What's going on 7th Street? Chaos going on the South.
I remember. So, yeah, just be prepared for that in a couple of weeks. So, and of course, with Maryland being right here, you know, Maryland's going to have a big crowd because, you know, usually it's in Chicago. I don't know why it's not in Chicago. I guess, I don't know, maybe they're switching it up. But it's usually in Chicago. This is the first time it's at.
Maybe they're going to send the ACC to Chicago this year.
And see, the ACC, I think, moved here because of the HB2 law in North Carolina.
Exactly.
That's why it got moved here.
And it was random, too, because no one knew about it. That's why I was.
No one knew about it. Like, I remember my brother said, I got tickets. And I'm like, to what? Like, oh, the ACC tournament. Like,
it's like, how?
Like, how? How are you getting there? It's down the street. Like, and I'm like, okay, whatever. Yeah. Anyways, another local team took an L, but they've been taking L's all year. Georgetown, 14-13, 5-9 in the Big East.
What did we say about Georgetown last year? He said that it might be time for the Thompson's legacy.
It might be time, man. It might be time.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with the Thompson legacy. It's a great legacy. We've
been having some lackluster teams the last few years.
Yeah.
Here in Washington, and we not about that life of having mediocre teams when it comes to Georgetown.
We got the Wizards now. We need to, like, we got to look good on the home front in basketball. Come on now, we had freaking Allen Iverson. We need
Patrick Ewing, Lonzo Mourning.
Can you name any of the players off of Georgetown right now?
I mean, right now, honestly, I don't know who is on their team.
I remember there was a guy named Green at one point. They was actually winning.
I mean, Jeff Green, yeah, he's in the NBA right now. Balling, went to Northwestern in Hyattsville.
Yeah. Again, local talent. Come on, get these local talents into your school.
Let me look up Georgetown's roster real quick. They are 9th in the Big East, so it does not look like they're making this tournament.
Oh, no, they're not.
Unless they actually win the Big East tournament.
March is next Wednesday. Can't be March Madness with that record.
I don't. Hold on. Is this? I'm looking at their roster right now. They have a freshman on the team for Georgetown. His name is George Mirsan. Not spelled like George that used to play for the Bullets, but I wonder if that's his son. Could be.
Might be.
He's 6'9". He could be. I understand George was 7'7", but I mean,
hey,
man,
he might have. Look, he's on the team, right?
Huh?
He's a freshman, right?
Yeah, he's a freshman. So it's likely it could be his child.
He could have a growth spurt at 20. You know, that's actually possible.
From Potomac, Maryland, it could be him. We'll have the Google.
Knowing the water system here in this area, yeah, your growth spurts can happen later. Just saying. I've seen a lot of grown men grow up real fast at 15 and 18.
We'll have to see who this who this kid is, if that's his, if this is his son. Anyways, back to what I initially saying. Yeah. I'm going to go through these names for the Georgetown players in order by jersey number, not necessarily by talent.
not good.
LJ Peak, he's a junior. Trey Campbell, junior.
Where they from?
Peak is from South Carolina. Trey Campbell's from D.C. I got to look up
I know
where
who Trey Campbell is.
Trey Campbell's from D.C.
I didn't know he was from Georgetown, though.
I wish ESPN would actually have more information on these people. I guess he doesn't play.
I guess
no,
we have to
plays.
Make a trip down to Georgetown to find out more things about them.
Okay, real quick. Jonathan Mulmore, Jagan Mosley, Reggie Cameron II, Ramon Hines, Jesse Gavon, George Mirson, Akoya Guy, Rodney Pryor, Marcus Dickerson, Derrickson, sorry, Caleb Johnson, Trey Mourning. I wonder if that's Alonzo Mourning's son.
That might be Alonzo Mourning's son.
And it's the kid is from Miami. Could be Alonzo Mourning's
son. Yeah.
Could very well be his son.
The Thompsons, of course. Dude.
And to wrap it up, he's 6'9", 230. He's a junior. Bradley Hayes. Was there anyone on there that you heard of?
Trey Thompson.
Oh, so you know what?
He's from here.
Like, I know he's from here. Yeah, I just don't
like,
know.
He's a pretty good high school baller. Like, but other than that, that's like a name of nobody. I'm not calling them nobody because they are somebody. I don't want to offend their mamas. You know.
Oh yeah. By the way, sorry, I don't want to cut you off. Yes, that is George Mirson's son.
Are you serious?
That it's not or George's because George was from Romania, so of course you know, came here to George. And his son goes by George.
So
it is his
so
son.
George A. Mirson, and oh my goodness, that's crazy. Does George Mirson live here now?
Yeah, I mean he works for the Wizards.
Oh, that's true. He do. Yeah. Oh, okay, wow.
I mean he works for them. He's part of like their organization.
Yeah.
Nepotism.
I'm
looking up Trey Mourning.
I bet you it's.
Let's son of Alonzo Mourning. Yes. So we have two sons of former NBA players on Georgetown. I understand, you know, George is a freshman. It looks like Trey's a junior. How did I not know there was a Mourning here? He averages let me look up his stats real quick. Actually, he barely plays. He's played 18 minutes this year.
Who?
Trey Mourning.
Wow.
I don't know if he's injured. He has quite a few DMPs.
That's not good.
Last year he played 117 minutes. Not a lot, really, but I mean, it is what it is. All right. So, quick, we've been all over the place, but also some other college basketball news before we move on to the NBA and talk about All-Star. Weekend, some other top 25 performances. Gonzaga is still undefeated, the only undefeated team in the country at 28-0. They are number one in the nation. They beat Pacific 82-61. I understand Gonzaga's in the West Coast Conference, which is known as a mid-major. However, I think they're still pretty good. I think they can compete with the Blue Bloods or the top the Power Five conference teams. So it's going to be interesting to see how they do when they get into the NCAA tournament. This probably is the best team that Gonzaga has had, but Gonzaga is kind of known as America's college basketball team because they're always pretty decent and everyone wants to see them succeed. But when it comes to tournament time, you know, they just can't get to the Final Four. Last year, I think they got to the Elite Eight, which was pretty impressive. However, you know, people want to see them get to the Final Four. I think this team could definitely get to the Final Four, especially behind guard Nigel Williams-Gross, who's a phenomenal guard for Gonzaga. Villanova number two, stomped Seton Hall 92-70. Kansas squeaked out a win over Baylor, number five Baylor 67-65. Arizona beat Washington 76-68. By the way, Washington has Markelle Fultz that went to DeMatha.
Whoa, okay.
Freshman.
That's a serious kid too.
Oh, he can ball.
Yeah.
And he is
he's
already broke
like ranked number 27 in the nation right now.
Yeah, he was a McDonald's All-American. Yep. And he already he's the all-time leading freshman scorer for Washington, and there's still time left in the season. UCLA at number 6. Man, they beat USC, their crosstown rival, by 32 points, 102-70. Bryce Alford, who is the coach's son, but is actually pretty good, like someone who actually deserves. You know, a lot of times, a lot of these coaches, they'll have their child play on the team, and they're not and they're not really doing anything. Now Bryce Alford is balling out here, especially as of late. He had 26 points, six assists. Lonzo Ball, also phenomenal freshman, played well during this game. Duke beat Wake Forest 99-94, and it was a back and forth competition down at Duke. And number 10, North Carolina beat number 14, Virginia, 65-41. Virginia, I don't know how you're number 14 in the nation with 6 ACC losses.
Who?
Virginia. 18-8.
Because of last year.
And number 14.
It's because of last year. That's all it is, because of last year.
I understand Maryland is in a whole different, you know, conference, and the Big Ten is down this year. But
they're kind of up. That's all.
But I don't understand how a team that is 22-5 is ranked. A team that's 22-5 in the Big Ten is below a Virginia team that's 18-8 in the ACC. And we're acting like the ACC and the Big Ten, like there's a big drop off. They're both
they're
Power
similar.
5 conferences.
Yeah, they are. Yeah.
Like if you're playing well in any of those conferences, you are playing well.
Exactly.
Like, it isn't like the Big Ten's a mid-major and ACC, you know, is a Power 5 conference. So I don't understand that. I don't understand the ranking. I understand Maryland. Maryland did lose to Nebraska on the road. Earlier this year, that might have been one of their bad losses, but I mean, the teams that they have lost to are pretty good in Maryland and in Virginia. We're going to see when the rankings come out later today where Virginia is, because Virginia's loss, I think, the last two games, one against Virginia Tech, which they should have won in regulation.
They're probably going to end up moving down like 5 spots.
I mean, yeah, if they drop down to 19 or 20, I mean, that's reasonable.
I don't think they should be ranked.
Oh, you don't think they should be ranked? Nah, I think they should be ranked.
18-8? Yo, there's got to be like 7 other teams that could be ranked right now.
I mean, Cincinnati, see, and they're in the American Conference.
That's a tough conference, dude.
It's funny. A lot of people say the American is a mid-major, but it's not. I think it's still, when it comes to basketball,
it's a major.
A major conference, because a lot of those teams came from the Big East. When the Big East dissolved, or the original Big East dissolved.
I think to be honest with you, I think the division that George Washington is in is actually
the Atlantic 10.
The Atlantic
pretty
10
good.
It's a major. I think that's a major conference for basketball.
Yeah.
For basketball, yeah.
Cincinnati is number 18, and they have a 24-3 record. With that's one loss within conference, 13-1.
That's sensible.
SMU, also in the same conference, 24-4. 19
in
the nation. Yes. South Carolina, 20-7, number 21 in the nation.
How many was it with the conference losses?
They're 10-4.
Still, yo, hold on. Why is
still
again,
less losses
why is
than
Virginia right now?
St. Mary's, yes, they're in the mid-major. Then the West Coast Conference, they're 24-3. That's kind of reasonable. Yeah, but even with three losses,
they're on the west side of that conference. That's not really that good in the west side of that conference. I hate to say it like that.
So yeah, it's interesting.
How's UCLA?
Notre Dame is 25, and they have a better record than better overall record and better ACC record than Virginia. I don't understand this. So we're gonna see how things play out.
Virginia, you guys are – somebody in, like, Virginia must be a part of the AP polling. It's like, I got to have my team in there.
Anyways, We've actually been rambling a lot, but we still have time for NBA talk. Let's get into NBA All-Star Weekend. Did you catch – I asked you about the All-Star game, but did you catch anything for All-Star Weekend? Like, what did you get, man?
The only thing I caught – do I got something here? Here we go. The only thing I caught was –
Porzingis. Oh, yes. Okay. Just come all over. You can't run out, blurt out Porzingis and not talk about. Okay.
Porzingis. Oh. Porzingis.
So how I know you're happy as a Knick fan, as a New York.
That was whack.
Native. He had an impressive Rising Star game, didn't he? For the world team.
He did. And man, All-Star game sucked, yo.
Okay, why did the All-Star game
suck? In the immortal words of my father, defense is part of playing basketball. Like, how do I say this? Like, all those guys are great. Steph Curry, great. LeBron James, great. Harden, great. You know, KD, great. But not if you're just like playing horse.
You don't like seeing 400 or close to 400 points and a half?
I mean, it's
that shit was retarded.
It was ridiculous.
It was like not even fun.
I understand your point. It is Steph why does it bother me? It doesn't bother me that they play this way is because it simply is an exhibition game in the middle of the year.
That's not even exhibition. An exhibition game, you would try to exhibit your defensive skills as well.
I like how you use the word.
You use the word in the word.
In your definition.
Right. Like, that's the definition of an exhibition. You exhibit shit. There was no defense exhibited. And that's my whole thing. It's like, I got so excited to watch this game with all the dudes I love.
Did you go to Dave and Buster's?
No, thank you. They know us by name there now, though. I will say that. Well, my whole point is this. Like, Porzingis, that was a skills challenge. So
yes,
at least he won some
shit.
Kyrie, he almost won. You know what I mean? The three-point contest.
Kyrie, we're going to talk about him later.
And the dunk contest was whack as fuck, too.
No, it was terrible. It was pretty
so
bad.
All I'm going to say is this. There's a white guy with green hair, but his hair's not green anymore. You know who I'm talking about?
No.
Who came out the crowd on that Facebook viral video.
I thought you were talking about Anderson from like my...
He's one of these weird sky-high dunker guys. You know what I mean?
Oh, that can't play basketball.
He's not a basketball player. He's just a dunker.
Uh-huh.
Long story, he came out during the third quarter intermission at the game last night with a few of his friends.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. Yeah,
that
was kind of brutal.
And grabbed the ball and like dunk, like crazy dunks. Like dunks that you want the pros
to
do.
Yeah.
But this kid is like, who knows? He's like 6'1", 6'2". Mm-hmm. He can jump out of the building. And literally, he runs, he grabs the ball in the air, runs past the hoop, and then dunks behind him.
I know who you're talking about.
Like
now.
That. And you're like, what? How is your arm even still in the socket?
Yeah. I know. Exactly
you know who I'm talking about, right?
Yeah.
He looks like a white guy.
I mean, he is.
He is a white guy. It's abnormal. It's abnormal.
I'm glad you said that and not me.
Not normal. He's like, clearly a white guy because his hair was green at one point.
But your boy Porzingis in the Rising Stars game, 33 minutes played.
Oh, you mean the world versus U.S.?
Yes, which I like the format.
I thought that was good because it's like, you know, Americans will want to not lose.
Yeah. And the world won.
Exactly. It's actually a real game.
41. Porzingis had 24 points, 11 for 16 from the field. But the MVP was Jamal Murray with 36 points.
But what's the cutoff? Like when you say you're a rising star, how many years have you?
The first two
years.
Rookie and your sophomore.
And your sophomore
season.
Year. So that's why unibrow was there.
Mm-hmm. And Porzingis will not be there next year.
By the way, he gets power from his unibrow.
You mean the unicorn?
What unicorn?
We're talking about Porzingis. He's
Oh, yeah, he is the unicorn, isn't he?
Yeah.
Wow.
The unibrow is Anthony Davis.
Wait, are you being serious?
Yeah, they call Porzingis
his nickname is the unicorn?
Yeah, like, which is crazy.
I thought you fumbled with your words.
Because he's white and majestic?
Yeah, because I thought he was talking
that's
about
probably
Anthony
why.
Davis. Yeah, exactly.
I never thought it all the way through.
That is the worst.
He's called the unicorn.
He's kind of majestic, though, like, because he just came out of nowhere. Like,
yes,
Porzingis.
And was
wow, he's...
Well, you had the Black Mamba.
Exactly, so. You know? Why not the unicorn?
The unicorn.
Yeah, he's
get it between the eyes.
Right.
That's actually a good. Hey, that's actually a good thing for him.
Shooter, so Jamal Murray, MVP of the Rise of Stars game.
Wow.
Had 36 points. He was phenomenal.
He was phenomenal.
9 for 14
phenomenal.
From the. And I'm not gonna lie. Wow. Jamal Murray plays for. I'm trying to remember which team he plays.
Isn't that
for.
Crazy? I don't know.
Oh,
either.
Denver. Yes, Denver. Yes, I know.
Their
he
only
went to
player.
That sounds about right.
He went. He went to Kentucky. And he was pretty good. The reason why he played on the world team is he's from Canada. Yeah, that's. I mean, that's why.
I know, right? You know, the Canadians. Are
by
like,
the way,
you guys, we're not really.
I didn't know Trey Lyles was. From Canada also.
Uh-huh.
He's from there.
Those Canadians are sneaky.
Lately,
you never
in the
know.
NBA, yes.
Yeah.
Andrew Wiggins.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, he's from Toronto.
Oh, snap.
Tristan Thompson's from, I think, like Toronto.
Really?
Or Canada for sure, but I think Toronto.
Yo, Akadabunda Kande, what about him, yo?
From Greece. Well, I forgot which
you're right,
African country, but by way of Greece.
Right,
yeah.
That's how he escaped.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yo, that guy's sick. Did we ever play the highlight of him dunking from the...
Not yet. It will come up. If we could...
If we could spell that guy's name, we could probably find the video.
Yeah. If you could put up the slam dunk contest video for me, please. Real quick, your thoughts on... I know you said something initially, but what were your thoughts
about
on...
About the dunk contest?
Yeah.
Oh, well, like... Yeah, yeah, you guys put up the dunk contest. The dunk contest, if the highlight of the dunk contest is a drone.
Uh-huh.
You've already started in a bad. You know what I'm saying? Like if I can't even put it in words, like if a robot is the highlight, then you've not done a good job. And that was stupid, by the way. I thought he was going to catch it out of midair. He let the ball drop and then that's just silly. That's just like, didn't he blow? Wasn't there a guy who blew out the candle on the cupcake one
time? Hey, that was impressive, Gerald Green.
Yeah. Like
I mean, he jumped super high.
No, but my point is, like, that was cute, like, because, like, it involved, like, jumping skills, and he had to blow it out and dunk. Like, I like that, right? But when you take a drone in, like, I don't know. I was expecting more things to happen, like the drone to fire bullets or something.
Okay.
A flamethrower.
Here's what's his name? DeAndre Jordan.
Oh, DeAndre Jordan was also. He's too big to be in a dunk contest. And,
yeah, but.
He'll come back.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, DeAndre Jordan, he's. This was his.
DJ Khaled should never, ever.
Oh, my God. I saw him in the celebrity game. He should never
that
be
was
there.
Stupid. Look at that. That's dumb. The whole thing is dumb. I think the whole thing is dumb. DJ Khaled is the worst basketball player in the history of basketball.
Uh-oh, Hugo.
I saw him take a shot, and it looked like.
Oh, it was horrible.
It was like. Dude, pull your pants up. Keep
losing
weight and find your key.
Here's Glenn
Robinson.
Snoop
Dogg said earlier about
that. Third.
How come the white guy couldn't hold it? How come the black guy had to hold it?
What?
Racist.
Okay.
Oh, see, now he's getting on his shoulder.
See, that's not racism.
Oh, okay.
That's
now,
reverse
now
racism.
Now it's okay.
That's literally reverse
now,
racism.
Now it's all right. It's all right. What the hell is the white guy doing there? Oh, hold the black guy.
Exactly.
That was Glenn Robinson the third.
Wow, that's actually pretty good.
That was, like, okay.
I mean, he did have to jump over two people.
Two people, yeah. And also, you got to think about their safety as well when you're getting over them.
Yeah. And this is someone holding another person.
Yeah,
exactly.
But how come the bottom guy's squatting? Like, come on, stand
and plus
up straight.
It's a backwards dunk as well.
Hater, dude. I'm hating the whole
I see.
Thing.
I see.
This whole contest I didn't like.
This is my issue with the...
That's all right. That's all right.
This is my issue with the slam dunk contest.
Okay, that's just whack. We've seen that before.
Yeah, like you have to do some new stuff and not drones.
And like he's wearing like the smallest shorts.
Yeah, his shorts, man.
And like that's been done before.
The issue with slam dunk contest...
Oh, look what he's wearing. Did you see the glasses he was wearing? Those were those new Snapchat glasses.
What are Snapchat glasses?
They are glasses you wear that snaps your chats.
Oh, wow.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
By the way, this guy, Derek, I think it's Derek Jones, or I can't.
My God.
As the young intern.
He's got the right body type for dunking, I will
he
say
was
that.
In the D-League earlier this year, got called up on a 10-day contract for the Suns.
I just need him to get bigger shorts. Just bigger shorts. I know what you're using.
I didn't watch
the Jackie Moon shorts on.
I did not watch it, so I think he was trying to pay tribute.
Yeah,
but,
I know.
But that's my only guess. I'm out here. By the way, this is the first time I'm seeing a lot of this.
Oh!
I didn't see that.
But
Ooh. I didn't see that.
You know what?
I must have fallen.
You know what
asleep.
Helps that though? Tighter shorts.
Like he couldn't have done that. That was a good dunk. I will give that. That's
with his
good,
left hand. That's and a I don't good, think he's left handed.
Yeah, that's pretty
oh,
good too.
Is,
yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but it's still a good dunk. That's a very good dunk. I'm sorry.
No. Overall, what your point is correct. Here's the bigger issue with the slam dunk contest. When and for you, I don't know what your age, how old
right?
you were. How old were you in 80? What was it, 87 with Jordan and you were 10. Okay. Jordan and Dominique.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, my God.
When you grow up with dunk contests like that,
you're going to look at everything else. Yeah.
Everything to live up. That's a good point.
Michael Jordan in 1987 was the biggest star in the NBA. Dominique Wilkins was one of the biggest stars in the NBA. Jordan, when he played it, Jordan competed, I think, in 3 or 4 slam dunk contests. All of them where he was the biggest attraction in the NBA outside of his rookie year.
But you know that he wasn't even the best player. Like he still wasn't the best player.
Exactly. Yet. The best players during that time was Magic and Bird.
Yeah.
But Michael Jordan was still the most popular player.
Exactly. He was like LeBron James.
He wasn't a bunch of no-names where you're like, oh, that guy's in the league? I didn't even know.
Yeah. Even as recent, and I say recent, 2000 with Vince Carter. Francis, Steve Francis, Tracy McGrady. They were stars when they competed.
Yeah.
The last 15 years, how many of the superstars actually participated in this? And I'm going to be real.
None.
If LeBron James, we spoke about how boring this was.
Yeah.
If LeBron James,
but LeBron's
boring. Hold on. If LeBron James, Kevin Durant, Russell Westbrook, if those guys actually competed in it, we would be saying the total opposite. Like, yo, this was probably one of the best things
and they would
out there.
On it, and they would, you know what I'm saying? They'd really try hard.
But when you got to be reaching for a D-League guy because of his YouTube videos.
He was a D-League player just weeks before.
When you got to reach for Glenn Robinson's son who does play but isn't like, he's like the fourth or fifth option, you know, on the Pacers, and when you got a DeAndre Jordan who's already 7 feet tall, where you're really not going to see the athleticism,
right?
Because he's already so
tall.
He's
mad athletic too, but it's just like, dude, what are you doing in the dunk contest?
Exactly.
Why? You never saw Ewing in the dunk contest. He could dunk.
So yeah, the big issue is it's just not enough firepower, not enough star power,
creativity.
But isn't it also a thing about willing?
Well, they're not willing because
like, Jordan was. They were excited to do it.
Exactly.
They were superstars, but were excited. Like LeBron, he literally does not want to do it.
And that's the bigger issue is a lot of these guys, Rude Jude says on XM. I know you know Rude
I
Jude.
I love Rude Jude.
Rude Jude, man.
Rude Jude.
Rude Jude just said, we just got a new generation of wussies. Like no one wants to compete because they might lose.
Yo, that's so
or they
true.
Might look bad. I think it's that too.
None of the star look players bad. Want to compete because they think
they don't want the optics of not
losing.
Winning. Right.
Like, you know what? Stupid. Dominique Wilkins did not win every time, but we still
they don't
remember.
Don't want the Jordan.
Even in losses, we remember how great the dunks were.
Yeah.
And Dominique Wilkins was like at points leading in scoring the entire league. He was the number one. It would be like if Steph Curry got into the dunk contest, which you know will never happen.
The issue, even Andrew Wiggins said when they asked him last year when the All-Star game was in Toronto, where he's from, they asked him, are you going to compete? And he was like, well, nah, because when I was in high school, I lost the McDonald's All-American slam dunk contest. I thought I should have won, but I lost, and I'm not feeling it anymore.
So I'll never try again. You said it. Bunch of wussies.
Well, they say if you punish people with bad things, like not giving them, awards,
then they stop might hurt trying.
Maybe they'll stop trying. That's why we give out those participation awards.
And see now,
the participation awards is killing us.
And see, LeBron James now, still athletic, by the way. LeBron James isn't as
athletic. Just doesn't
want to
do it.
Have you seen him do before games?
Yeah.
Like he would win a slam dunk contest.
I know.
With the dunks he does in warm-ups. Like, he would win. I remember.
He would easily
this
win.
Was, I'm trying to tell you the season, which season it was. It was the 2009 season. I went to
the
Wizards.
Witness season?
I went to the Wizards Cavaliers.
Yeah, that's
this
witness,
guy
yeah.
did in warm-up, off the backboard, caught it, put it between his legs, dunked it. He did that way before someone did it in the slam dunk contest.
How long ago was it?
This was like 2009.
This is the witness year, like when he was doing the powder and everything.
And yet, like, when he was doing all of that stuff, he didn't want to, like,
he didn't even do it then. That's the year that we found out he didn't want to do it. It was like,
and then
what?
It was like, hold on,
like,
but you're doing this
do
during warm-ups.
Exactly.
Can we talk for 2 seconds about Gilbert Arenas' statement?
Which statement did he say?
What did he say?
About when the
no thoughts over 35.
Yes,
NBA
I saw
All-Star
that. Should be
weekend.
A, I mean, he said, give it a, he said, he was kind of like my mom. My mom talks about this when it comes to people who work somewhere and they're like 70 and 80. And just, my mom said, why don't you just give the young people an opportunity?
What? Why is Gilbert Arenas the crotchiest, crankiest dude like of all time?
Because his exit was horrible.
And Gilbert just said, let these young women flourish.
Did you see him break into what's his name's house? Nick Young's
Nick
house?
Young, yes,
yo?
He's a clown.
He broke into
Nick Young's house and filmed the whole thing clowning him.
Yes, yes, yes.
Like straight, like he, I can't, like Nick Young is with
jail.
His kid.
By the
Nick
way,
Young's like with his child. Yes.
By the way, Gilbert Arenas is Floyd Mayweather of the courts. He has not lost in court at all.
Yeah, he's
He's had over 20 litigations in court. He's undefeated.
Yeah, he's
the Floyd Mayweather.
For what?
For all sorts of stuff. Child. He gets child
gun
support.
Gun charge? Like he won with the gun charges here. Like he got
I mean,
out of the gun
the
charges.
That's the only thing he's lost, technically.
He didn't lose it, though. Because think about what he did. He didn't really spend jail time.
He didn't spend
any jail time. He basically just went to
a halfway house.
I don't understand. How could he be getting child support?
Because
he doesn't work? He's unemployed?
Yes. His contract ended. And what's her name?
He has no endorsements.
Was wilding out, so he got custody of the kids. So of course he gets child support.
That's the wildest thing I've ever heard.
And by the way, he was ordered to pay for tuition for the kids. And he said when his contract ended, he said I can't afford it. It's $90,000 a year for tuition. I can't afford it.
So
I'm taking him to public school. And he won the proceeding. The court said, all right, you don't have to do that. You're right. You don't make any money right now. So, yeah, take your kids out of private school. I mean, he's the Floyd Mayweather
Dude,
of court.
What
you know?
The hell?
All right, back.
I didn't mean so that to be such a tangent. I don't mess with him, though, real
Floyd Mayweather.
I'm not
going
to mess with Gilbert Arenas. We shouldn't even talk about him. He's in the legal
like
system like that.
Walk in and punch me in the head.
Gilbert is
I feel like
man,
he's
going to
like sue us for defamation. Like,
and,
he hears
and win.
Us.
And win.
And
anyway,
win.
So let's show the highlights from the All-Star game. I think there's a top 10
what
plays.
What type of highlights would there be? I mean, that would be like an hour long. Were you going to show all the dunks?
No. I mean, it's only the top 10 plays. We gonna see how they are. I'm going to be real. I did not actually watch the All-Star game. I watched the last
You're
minute.
About to watch it. You're about to watch it.
I took
this highlight reel will be basically what happened.
And then I watched the replay only the first quarter. I watched that, and then I started watching Hoarders on eight. I watched the first 48, actually, first, and then I watched Hoarders for like two
I
hours.
Am a sports journalist who's admitting to watching Hoarders instead of the NBA.
The
it's not like there was like a big game on. It's I'm, only all of the greatest NBA
when
stars
you get,
at
When
one
you
time.
Get older, man, like, like 5 years ago, I didn't miss any sporting event, man. I didn't.
Yo,
I
it was the worst All-Star game I have ever seen, and I always hate the All-Star games. This one was especially bad because there was an especially lacking defense. Like it was just obvious that they said to each other beforehand, "Yeah, just go ahead, go ahead, shoot, dunk, whatever you want. You know, it just doesn't matter."
Score was 192-182. West won. MVP was Anthony Davis with an absurd amount
of
number points. I think it was like 50, and I'm looking at it right now.
NBA
he had
comment 51, number 10
51 or something like that.
Frozen.
Anthony
here
Davis,
goes
52
DeMar
points,
DeRozan
26 for 39.
Yeah,
you're. I mean,
are these the top 10?
I don't have an issue. I don't have an issue with the type of play.
Look, there's no one even down there. Look at that. There's like one guy who's like just watching to make sure it goes up.
Again,
I mean, it's still better
Steph
than
Steph Curry lay on the floor.
I saw that. Steph Curry lay on the ground because he did not want to be in a posterized position.
By the way, Durant threw a lob for Westbrook.
I was talking
the world went crazy.
He
actually passed the ball to each other.
Yeah, yeah.
And I love Westbrook. Westbrook is really, you know what?
He looked like he wanted to play, though. He wanted, like, I want to play.
He's always wanted to.
Did anyone catch if they spoke with each other?
No, they didn't. Here's the hoop right here. The world went crazy after this.
It did.
He couldn't even tell it was Westbrook. Had he looked over to realize it was Westbrook, he would have kept it himself. There's no doubt he didn't even see that.
I could have been a mean crossover if he didn't lose the ball.
James Harden.
Crossover.
Easily stripped.
Great creep right there.
That one, good for number five.
Yeah.
At number four, the chance on parade.
Here's is that
Kyrie?
Is that no? That's Wall. Is that Kyrie? No, that's
Kyrie.
Yeah,
off the backboard. I love that midair thought. Look at this. Do I shoot? Do I drive? Uh-oh. What do I do? I throw it to my.
By the way, Kyrie Irving said the world is flat.
More from the
yeah, he said that, and
I think
he needs to never, ever be in front of a microphone.
Here's Curry on the ground.
Shaking my head.
He wasn't trying to be on that poster.
I found this funny, actually. I really did find this funny. Look, up.
Never again.
I thought that was funny. I found that actually funny.
Yeah, watch your head, young fella.
You thought Steph learned,
here it goes.
But he
that's why he was on the ground.
That.
Oh.
Look at this. Give me that.
And then he's looking at, like, did you see Curry? Hold on. You got to rewind. You got to rewind to see Curry.
Gotta
rewind.
It's great.
Like nobody else in the game. The
you gotta see.
We got the new guy.
No problem.
As LeBron James.
Oh,
there's no rewinding.
Okay, all right. No, that's cool. But did you see how Curry was like, y'all weren't gonna tell me he was coming? Y'all weren't gonna tell me.
He was so mad. After I lay down, you didn't want to remind me he's about to dunk on my head. Right.
But so
he's the freak. Freak
is.
Anthony good.
Anthony Davis MVP in the hometown of New Orleans. Remember this game was played in North Carolina, but because of their discriminatory
look at this. Give me.
Get off of me.
But because of their
discriminatory
law on gender.
North Carolina, y'all a bunch of bigots. Burned. Stop that shit. Knock that shit off. That's some bullshit.
And I know they missed out on the money for this, too.
You're going to miss out on a lot more, too.
Yeah, definitely a lot more. There was some news last night, though. DeMarcus Cousins traded.
Where?
Where did he go?
To the Pelicans, so he did not have to leave New Orleans.
So he just stayed. He went to the NBA All-Star game and stayed.
They said, just,
y'all can just stay. Y'all can send my bags. Okay, cool.
He was traded for Buddy Hield. Langston Galloway.
Are the Pelicans in contention for the playoffs?
They are three games behind the eighth seed.
Three games?
With 25 games left.
You faked me out on that. They are three games behind the eighth seed.
So they.
So what? They only take the top 10. No, eight.
Yeah.
They only
take
the
top eight.
Yeah, so they are.
They're not going to make it.
They're in contention.
They're not going to make it.
They're in contention. But they traded DeMarcus Cousins for Buddy Hield, Langston Galloway, which I accidentally
Buddy
said.
Hield, they traded Buddy Hield away from him? That's not smart. Buddy Hield, they need Buddy Hield. Sorry.
Langston Galloway, which I accidentally called him Langston Hughes the other day.
writing
I'm
stories.
Sure he appreciates that.
I mean, that should be a compliment.
He writes stories on the court.
Are there people named Langston that weren't named after the poet?
Exactly. He should be honored that I confused him with a great.
You're
anyways,
welcome.
Tyreke Evans, also a first round draft pick this year and a second next year for DeMarcus Cousins.
Damn.
So
they gave up a lot.
They gave up a lot.
Two first round draft picks in consecutive years.
Yeah, first and a second. So,
a second round draft.
Yeah,
pick.
Second round draft pick.
Okay.
The following
year. That's a lot,
year.
Though. Three
I think
players.
I think it's still a lot, but we're going to see. What if this team makes the playoff? This is where I think the trade works for the Pelicans if DeMarcus Cousins actually stays after this season, because he can just opt out.
That's true. He definitely can opt out. After, that's why I said it was year. A bad
so show. Like, it could just be a rental.
They but rent him.
So glad you said exactly what the problem was.
That's an expensive rental.
And we're also going to see, is DeMarcus Cousins really crazy? Because if he starts acting up the way he was in Sacramento with the Pelicans, then we just know he's just a terrible player, a terrible teammate, terrible player for an organization. I mean, you're going to be playing against with Anthony Davis. I understand they're two big men, but Anthony Davis actually doesn't mind playing the four. You could play the five. Now, are you going to double-team Anthony Davis? Are you going to double-team DeMarcus Cousins? Like, they're going to get single coverage, so you're going to get good looks from those guys. They do probably need to make another trade to at least get a guard to help out because they did miss out on Tyreke Evans and Buddy Hield. Yes, they have Drew Holiday, who recently came back from his hiatus from taking care of his wife. He is a decent point guard, but if they get another guard, that would help. We're going to see
how
this goes.
They're banking on something. That's what they're doing right now. They're banking on something. They already got it invested.
There must be something we don't know about because that's a big trade.
And the trade, literally, it was like the rumor came out Sunday afternoon, and then it was done Sunday night. Like, no one thought it was going to happen because the Kings were saying, yo, we're not trading Cousins to everyone. The Celtics approached them.
You know who owns the Kings.
The Clippers approached them. A few other teams approached him with DeMarcus Cousins. Cousins was like, "Nah, I mean, we're not trading Cousins." And then
it's actually, I'm gonna be honest with you, for the Kings, it's actually a good thing because they didn't lose anything. They're not going to impact anything.
Well, they're closer to rebuilding than the Pelicans.
I mean, Buddy Hield can end up being a good player.
That's why I said Buddy Hield is expensive, man.
With DeMarcus out of there, I think the young guys. Especially
work.
Like Willie Cauley-Stein, I think.
Yes, yeah.
I think they can finally like flourish, and also you get like DeMarcus Cousins is not a great teammate in the locker room.
Yeah.
Like he caused a lot of things. DeMarcus Cousins already has 17 technical fouls, so every technical foul that he gets for the remaining of the year, he's going to be suspended for a game. Like that's how many techs he's
is
got.
Is there anyone that has more?
No. He already was suspended last week.
No. Never mind.
He already was suspended last week for a game because he got a technical foul.
But
in
how
game.
Do you get 17 technical
the
fouls?
Rule is
that's halfway 17, point.
Yo.
Like 17 the rule is
halfway through the season.
The rule is after 16, then they start suspending you
that's
for
crazy.
What's next.
His deal?
I think he didn't want to play.
He's argumentative. Can't get along with coaches. They've had. In the last, since Rick Adelman, they've had 9 coaches in 7 years. DeMarcus Cousins is the reason why they've had so many coaches. When he gets upset, when he doesn't get a call, then he fouls down on the other end of the court, gets angry at the referees. He whines and complains. We're going to see if he was just frustrated with what's going on in Sacramento or if this is just
who he is. I think it's mainly because he was frustrated.
I mean, I hope that's what it is, because if it doesn't work here, I mean, he's still going to make money. He'll still be in the NBA.
He'll just be looking at a liability.
Yeah, everyone would. He'll never be on a good team because no good team will want to take a chance.
But you know what Sacramento has been used for the NBA for the longest time, other than LA Clippers. That was a dumping place. Like, think about how many people got dumped there.
Siberia
it was the Clippers. Now it is
Sacramento. And remember, at one point, I personally believe the NBA was behind it. They dumped so many players to the point where Sacramento actually was a good team.
Yeah, Chris Webber and
D-Box. Exactly.
It backfired.
Those guys were dumped. The graveyard came alive.
Those guys got sent there through these trades, and then it was like, oh, we actually got a team.
Yeah. We actually traded into a good situation.
Some trade rumors. Here we go. You want to hear some trade rumors?
Yeah.
Jimmy Butler, possibly to the Boston Celtics. And the Celtics are going to be.
The Celtics are two players away from being great.
The Celtics are going to be in every trade rumor because they own the draft. the Nets draft picks.
Yeah.
And the Nets are going to are guaranteed to get a top five pick.
Hey, so, by the way, University of Central University. Oh, no, no.
North Carolina Central.
Central University is bus is like really.
I saw that
out
bus
front.
Just now, and I was just kind of like, they're probably here to play Howard for something.
Probably tomorrow or something.
But
all right,
pretty dope.
Well, Jimmy,
now you threw me off. Oh,
Jimmy Butler to the Celtics.
Sorry, I did throw
Jimmy
you off.
Butler, and who would the Celtics give up?
The
or is
Celtics
it not that far?
Possibly will give up Marcus Smart, Jay Crowder, and draft picks. Also, Paul George rumored to be traded. Also to the Celtics because the Celtics, like I said, have that pick. So the Celtics are really in play for really anyone.
Indiana would give up Paul George?
Paul George. Did I say Paul Pierce?
You said Paul
George. Yeah, Paul George. Paul George. Yes, Paul George. That's what I'm talking about.
On Indiana, right?
Yeah. Yes, Paul George
from
Indiana.
Their best player.
Yeah, because, I mean, they're in that position where if you're not good, you might as well tank and then get good later. That's just how it is.
Okay.
Also, don't be surprised if Melo's on the move. But, of course, the only team that looks like it might happen is either the Cavs or the Clippers. Trade deadline is on Thursday.
Please take
him. We're going to see how things go.
Please, whoever you are, rich billionaire men, please come forward and take Melo off my team so we can start winning games. I ask of you nicely.
Ted, you need to bring him here.
Also,
okay, he's a good bench player.
Also, the Wizards are in talks. For Lou Williams from the Lakers.
Wizards looking good these days.
I love Carmelo.
By the way, I went to the Wizards game.
I love Carmelo. Yeah. I got a couple friends that know Carmelo, but I want the other guy. I'm sorry.
Lou Williams possibly going to come here.
I want Lou Williams.
By the way, I went to the Wizards game against the
Bradley
Thunder.
Beal's a beast.
Yes. Should have been in an all-star game, but anyways.
They beat the Thunder, right?
Yeah, I got my free Chick-fil-A sandwich because Jeremy Grant missed two free throws in the fourth quarter.
Nice.
So I want to thank you, Jeremy Grant, for being a bum at the free throw line. I understand you went to Dematha. I understand you're a local guy, but I'm still glad that you missed those two free throws for me to get my Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich. I actually got two of them because then I got another ticket and I went later.
Wow. I now know what to bribe you with.
You can definitely bribe me with Chick-fil-A chicken sandwiches or their nuggets.
Okay.
The only nuggets that I could possibly eat like 20 at a time because they're that good.
Yeah, they are good.
They are that good. How much time we got, Mike? 3 minutes. All right. Doesn't leave much time for what I wanted to talk about, but it shouldn't take long. The NFL, even though it is not in session, there's some newsmaker. Darrelle Revis charged with 4 felony counts with assault for assaulting 2 gentlemen. He allegedly assaulted them after one of the gentlemen pulled out his cell phone, started recording Darrelle Revis while he was walking down the street. Darrelle Revis allegedly got angry, took the cell phone, tried to delete the video, threw the cell phone into the road. A second gentleman retrieved the cell phone. The two gentlemen then approached Revis. And all they remember is they woke up and the paramedics and police were talking to them. Allegedly, Darrelle Revis and another assailant beat up these two guys and they were knocked unconscious.
Wow. Oh, we were saying how great he was, and then the next thing I know, I woke up in the hospital.
So this
Did
happened.
We have video of this?
This happened in Pittsburgh. I mean, no video yet. There may be video because they may release what was actually recorded on the cell phone. This is my opinion of what happened. It can be totally false.
They said, you're not an island.
I think it could have been that. I think Revis felt threatened because two men were following him in the middle of the night. And, like, you know, it happens a lot where as a celebrity, you just get followed and it can go left. And he probably asked them to stop, and because they didn't, out of frustration, he tried to stop them. But then, after he threw the cell phone away, they then approached him again. So at that point, if you did that to me, I mean, I'm going to have my guard up, too. And I'm going to be like, all right, we might have
Why are people following celebrities, you know, filming them? Don't do that.
Yeah, so we're going to see how things go. He was charged, released on non-monetary bail.
There's too much of that these days. Don't do that to people. Yeah,
people don't throw cell phones because cell phones can hurt people.
Also, I know you all will be happy when I say this. Tony Romo looks like he'll be released from the Dallas Cowboys.
I'm not happy that he's going to be released. I don't know where he's going to end up.
Right?
No, no, don't even talk about this.
Redskins.
You love the wish deal on your
this shit would be funny as fuck, though. You would see memes from my account all day, every day.
I mean, as
you would see the angry memes from me. It'd literally just be my face throwing bricks at TVs.
Yo, watch that be the one thing that could actually help the Skins win.
Hey, man.
I will be happy if it does, but other than that, no.
Never.
Yeah, man, I want to thank everyone for watching and listening. Stay tuned to the – yes, I was about to say, stay tuned to follow the Twitter page, Sports Reality LV. We have the NCAA Tournament Bracket Challenge. Winner gets 2 tickets to the Wizards-Miami Heat game season finale. So, of course,
fill out your brackets because on the 12th they announce the teams.
Yeah, March 12th.
Sunday, March 12th, they announce the teams. And then that Wednesday, you guys, we need your brackets to be submitted because you can win 2 tickets to the last home game with the Miami Heat and the Washington Wizards.
Yes, yes, yes. So we'll keep you posted on that, of course, when the page is actually created because we can't really create it until the selection. Until
the teams are announced.
But just giving you
Sunday,
a heads
March 12th. Stay tuned.
Just giving you a heads up to stay tuned for that, and the winner gets tickets to the Wizards game. Want to thank you, Boom, for everything. Want to thank you, Mike. The new engineer, man. What's your name, man? Thank you. Thank you, Kyle.
He popped out.
I'm Kyle. Let me tell you what his name is from the back of here. Instead, his name is Kyle.
Kyle, we want to thank you, Kyle. Everything went smoothly, man. Until next time, everyone, Sports Reality, peace.
Peace.